2020 is confirmation. Very special as well, very unique. I mean, it's wonderful your preparation of your catechists, of your parents, leading to this event, to this sacrament. Not only happens once, and so that's why it's so unique and special. Peace be with you. Let us ask the Lord to forgive us.
Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and lead us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty and merciful God, that the Holy Spirit, coming near and dwelling graciously within us, may make of us a perfect temple of His glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, I charge you in the presence of God and of Christ Jesus, who will judge the living and the dead, and by his appearing and his kingly power, proclaim the word, be persistent, whether it is convenient or inconvenient. Convince, reprimand, encourage through all patience and teaching. For the time will come when people will not tolerate sound doctrine, but following their own desires and insatiable curiosity will accumulate teachers and will stop listening to the truth and will be diverted to myths. But you, be self-possessed in all circumstances. Put up with hardship, perform the work of an evangelist, fulfill your ministry. For I am already being poured out like a libation, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have competed well, I have finished the race, I have kept the faith. From now on, the crown of righteousness awaits me, which the Lord, the just judge, will award to me on that day, and not only to me, but to all who have longed for his appearance. The word of the Lord.
Sacrament of Confirmation, please stand up. Bishop Estevez, I present to you these young people of St. Joseph's Parish who have completed a period of preparation for confirmation. They have deepened their knowledge of Jesus Christ by studying the truths of our faith. They have been strengthened by God's grace in the sacraments, and they have been supported by the prayers and example of our parish community. I now ask you to celebrate the completion of their initiation into the life of Christ and to seal them with the gift of the Holy Spirit.
Sebastian, and you must feel very proud to have this magnificent group of young people, of teens, receiving today the Holy Spirit at this big parish of St. Joseph. And I welcome Father Giovanni of the Albanian Community Mass for being with us this morning, this afternoon, and for the three families that are presenting their their sons and daughters from the Albanian community. And I thank Father John for serving as MC and Deacon Clay for presenting this. He will share the letters that have been chosen at the end of this homily, and later on, after communion, he will share as well. As you know, for the families who may not know, Deacon Clay will be ordained not next Saturday, but the following, along with Deacon Mo Colbert and four more deacons. They will all be ordained priests on June 20th at 11 o'clock. And you can connect with us because it will be steamed, and I hope you do. I hope that you join Deacon and his family, beautiful family, in his ordination to the priesthood, a very sacred day. And 2 weeks after, he will come to celebrate Mass for you. The gospel that Deacon Clay proclaimed for us this morning, this afternoon, is a very tiny story of what is known as the poor widow. And Jesus, as we heard, just to recollect what was proclaimed, Jesus was in front of the temple of Jerusalem. And at the moment, there was a collection, but we have the offertory collection of funds. And like in any community, you have the upper class, the wealthy class, and you have those in the middle, and then you have the very poor, all of the poor, the less affluent. And Jesus was observing what was going on, and he makes a comment. What comment does Jesus make? He says, you know, there are rich people who they give in their generosity, but they give of their surplus because they have a lot of surplus. But the poor, like this lady who put 2 coins, she gave it all what she had. And Jesus praised that poor lady because she had given all what she had. She loved to the extreme. She gave to the extreme. And Hans Urs von Balthasar, a great theologian, has said that this little parable is the synthesis of the entire gospel. Everything that Jesus wanted to teach is here in this parable, tiny parable. And I can relate to that because when I was a pastor in Miami, we were in the process of building a new church. which is called St. Agatha, and it's across the Florida International University in Miami. And that project took 3 years of building that church. And there was a lady who every Monday would bring a sack of coins. She had a tiny little business in Sweetwater, a section of Miami. And there she had a little store, probably of candies, coffee, you know, very simple. And as people would, a dollar they would pay, 75, they had a dollar, those 25, she would put it in that sack. And so for 3 years, every Monday, she would come to the sack of the building of the church. She reminds me of this widow of Jesus dying. Because she didn't have a lot. She was an immigrant from Nicaragua and newly arrived. But yet she wanted to be part of building a house for God, building a house for worship of the God one and three, one and triune. And on the day of the blessing of the dedication of the church, February 5th, 2000, the famous year of the year 2000, I said very few words in the dedication, but I thank her. I said, because people like you have built this church. And so I, like Jesus, was in awe of what she had done. But in reality, if you talk to missionaries, they easily will tell you stories like this in the missions. You know, where people of very limited means go out of their way in being generous, even if what they have to give is little, 2 coins. But the story is also of our own diocese. Thank goodness the bishop's annual appeal is able to succeed because of the generosity of everybody. And thank goodness we have the wealthy who really make a difference. But we also have those people who barely have unemployment, who are in a very difficult situation in their families, and yet they participate because they are part of this particular church and they want to be part of the charities for the poor and the needy and the important causes that Bishop's Appeal contributes. As you are aware, this is the year of St. Joseph. St. Joseph, even the Diocese of Venice, southwest of Florida, is having this year of St. Joseph. And we are fortunate to have this magnificent parish, St. Joseph, but our neighboring parish, San Jose, is the Spanish version of St. Joseph. Well, St. Joseph is the English version of San Jose. But we have St. Joseph Academy. And we have the Sisters of St. Joseph. So this parish community, this diocese community, is blessed with that affirmation of St. Joseph. This is why we have this year give thanks for the presence of St. Joseph. And the scriptures have one word about St. Joseph. That word in Greek is dikaios. And dikaios means righteousness. He was a righteous man. In English, we would say he was a man of integrity, a man of truth, witness the truth. And a question to the confirmandi here, there's two white lines, red lines. What can you say that St. Joseph, something that he said that is found in the gospel? Could you please tell me? You can stand up and say it aloud so that everybody could hear what you have to say. Well, I can't understand why you are mute, because he didn't say anything. There is not one word of Joseph. He taught by his deeds, by his actions, and his actions were holy. And, you know, Pope Francis has a great devotion to St. Joseph, and in his bedroom, he has an image of St. Joseph next to him. That image, Joseph is sleeping, a dormant Joseph. Now, why do you think that we have that image of the sleeping Joseph, the sleeping Joseph? Would anyone of the confirmandi know? I was this morning in resurrection, parish confirming. And two kids had an answer for that. Yeah, you can stand up and say when you have the answer. Well, I think you are intimidated by Father Sebastian, as he said. Well, St. Joseph, as you know, had a lot of dreams, and God talked to him in dreams. And at times, we are a little bit hard-headed, and probably God can only get to us in our sleep. And God mentioned to Joseph how to deal with Mary's pregnancy, of which he was not the father of the child. And when King Herodes was killing children in a dream, once again, God told him, move away, take the mother and the child, move away. And St. Joseph was always obedient to the will of God. And what he would perceive, this is what God wants, he would do it. He was a righteous man, a man of truth. I know, and you know, that he's also the patron of the Holy Death. And so I hope that in my moment of passing from this world to life after earth, I hope that St. Joseph will be with. I hope that I will remember him at that time. He's also the patron of the Universal Church, of the Global Church, of the Catholic Church throughout the world. He's the patron, and we are so blessed to think of Joseph today. I also would like in this Mass to thank very especially Father Jan Sole, who is serving today as Master of Ceremony. Father Jan has been serving this parish community with distinction, because I always hear it from you. I hear it in the restaurants, I hear it in neighborhoods, in family visits, in letters that I receive, in emails. He gets a lot of recognition for his leadership, for his teaching, for his care, for his very talented and wonderful homilies. And I thank you, Father John, for Father Sebastian's delegating you to be coordinating the meaning of renovating this church that is so beautiful as you come into it. I had not seen it until now, and I am impressed. Also, it's the Cody Center so impressed. And I know that there is more to come, thanks to your generosity and support to the campaign. Lord, Father John has done so well, so well here at St. Joseph. I thank Father Sebastian for guiding and mentoring such an experienced pastor as you, mentoring a young priest in his first years of priesthood. But certainly I know, as I thank Father John, I know that Father John would thank you, because a priest is a priest in serving the community, and the community enhances the life of the priest by your love and by your support and your collaboration. And all what Father John has done with the youth, in caring for the youth ministry, at the school, he is so present every week. You parents, I know that you feel a lot of gratitude and support for the presence of a caring priest. And so today we celebrate this Eucharist on the eve of the Trinity. And I would like to end with a poem to the Holy Spirit by Jessica Powers. Jessica Powers was a philosopher in Chicago and entered religious life and entered the Carmelite community in Wisconsin from where she was from. And her comments to the her poems to the Holy Spirit or related to the Holy Spirit are so rich, so insightful, saying so much with such few words. I think that's the genius of an artist, with a very limited scope, communicates so much. And may I ask a girl, confirmandi, perhaps Miss Hartwell is here. Miss Hartwell. Read your letter. Yeah, will you come and share with the community this poem of Jessica Powers, whose name, the name of the poem, is the Spirit name, the Spirit's name.
To God, oh,
bishop has asked me to read the highlights of a few selected letters that the confirmandi have written to the bishop that really highlight the richness of this confirmandi class. Bishop has selected a few letters, and I will read the selections, and I will first read out the name of each letter. I ask that the confirmandi please stand so we can recognize you as I read the segment that Bishop has asked me to read. The first letter is from Julie Habush. Julie says, I have prepared for confirmation by using the Decision Point book by Matthew Kelly. He created a religion book that prepares you for confirmation. It has really helped me prepare for confirmation. It has given me tips and helpful ideas to grow closer to God. I have used some of these tips to help me. One of the things I have used from Decision Point is that I use the prayer process. There are 7 steps. Gratitude, awareness, significant moments, peace, freedom, others, and then pray the Our Father. This process has helped me become closer to God by praying for everything that has been on my mind and by thanking God for everything too. Thank you, Julie. The next letter, we can hold the applause to the end. The next letter is from Charlie Denson. I also think that a great way to bring young people today back into the faith, or just into the faith, is by showing how happy we Catholics are as a people. Thank you, Charlie. Next letter is from Rihanna McMillan. I plan to shine Jesus' love and power upon the culture and show them what life is about, serving God and each other. I will start small by preaching to my peers and eventually reach the point of publicly speaking about God and delivering the gospel message to countries where the Bible is banned. Thank you, Brianna. These are rich. They've really inspired me by reading these. The next one is from Natalie Reinholz. She says, praying can take time, and time is precious to you, and your life is busy and chaotic, but that is when we need prayer the most. We need to separate ourselves from the messiness of the world around us and spend some time with our true friend, Jesus Christ, so he can show us the way, how we should grow, who we are, and where our lives are meant to go to help others. Thank you, Natalie. Kelsey Valdivia. The Word of God can change a person's life in such a wonderful, unexplainable way. Some people still have not heard of God. It is our responsibility as Catholics to spread the Word of God so others may experience the same joy that we experience. Thank you, Kelsey. Micah Furto. In my family, in the Catholic Haitian culture, it's often emphasized how important these sacraments are. For example, my baptism and First Holy Communion were both major events that many of my family members travel for. We wear detailed and expensive dresses to the ceremony to celebrate that sacrament, making sure that we get the message of how special this event truly is. This also ties into my reasoning for choosing my patron saint, Saint Josephine Bakita. She is one of the few African-American saints who had to endure the hard conditions of slavery. As my patron saint, she would remind me that even in the toughest times of my life, God will always be right there as my aid. Thank you, Mika. Anthony Mighty. My Bible is my dad, and he's the reason we go to a good school, because he thinks a good education is important. He is a good example because he went to college and got a college degree in science and math. He takes us to church, and I want to follow in his footsteps. I'm also good at science and math. I don't know yet what I want to do with my life, except to be a good, moral citizen who follows the teachings of the church. I know that I will pray to God to lead me and help me through my life. He will stick with me for all time. Thank you, Anthony. William Michael Hiscock. I see Jesus as my teacher, Lord, and Savior. I look to Christ in times of joy and pain, and in times of uncertainty. To put your faith in something that is assured is easy. To put your faith in something you truly know not is hard. Yet I have found that the harder it is to keep your faith, the stronger your faith is. Well, that's very profound. William, thank you. Luke Noche. Luke says, the Eucharist is a tangible reminder and helps me to remember that Jesus died on this cross for us. Every Sunday, his presence reminds me that I should be as faithful as possible in order to honor Jesus' sacrifice. It comforts me to know that as long as I live by God's teachings, and never forget what Jesus did for us, I may be able to go to heaven, where people will be able to agree and stop trying to put themselves ahead at the expense of the rest of the world. I also want to point out that Bishop highlighted that Luke wants to be an astrophysicist when he grows up, and also how we need to have, especially in our world today, this harmony that the church teaches of faith, science. Thank you, Luke, for that example. And Sarah Hartwell, who shared the poem with us today. Sarah says, I love Jesus very much, and ever since I was little, I have seen him as a big brother to me. He helps me to see how much he loves me and protects me. I love Jesus so very much, and I visit him in adoration every Wednesday. And I go to Mass to receive him in the most holy Eucharist every Tuesday, Thursday, and Sunday. I love to picture myself as a soldier in God's army, and I am helping fight the battle that we have been given to fight. Sometimes I may not want to pick up the sword and the shield to keep on fighting, but I know that I must to achieve the goal of heaven. Sometimes I just need some help, which is why God gave me friends and family, so that we can watch each other's backs and to help encourage each other to keep on fighting till we are taken to join God in heaven. Thank you, sir. This is from Gabriel Quinn. For my confirmation name, I chose St. Augustine. What stood out to me about him is his honesty he had towards God, and that he tasted most of what the world had to offer and felt empty by it. I think that he will help me remind me that the only lasting happiness is in God. Amen. The last one is by Casey Marie Montour. I've always wondered why everyone always says you change at confirmation. And it took me some time to understand that they mean spiritually, not mentally or physically. I also realized that we don't change unless we allow it. I've never really understood what the Holy Spirit is, but studying for confirmation opened a lot of doors for me. It helped me realize that the Holy Spirit is the love of God in his Son. It also helped me realize how much God and Jesus want me to know, love, and serve them. how much they want to get me to listen to them, how much they love me and want me to be with them forever in heaven. I know that confirmation is the big turning point from growing from a child of Christ to a soldier of Christ, and I am prepared to fight for my faith and try to lead people to the church. I want to always stay with our faith. I understand that this is bigger than you and me. It's bigger than my family. It's bigger than my country. I know this is bigger than anything. This is about God, the creator of the earth, the creator of humanity. It's a beautiful letter to end with, in case you need it. These letters really sum up the richness of our faith. I'll leave you with that as we prepare for you to receive the gift of the Holy Spirit.
Perhaps at this moment, only those receiving the sacrament may remain standing. Do you renounce Satan and all his works and empty promises? Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the only Son of Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who today, through the sacrament of confirmation, is given to you in a special way, just as the Lord was given to the apostles on the day of Pentecost? Do you believe in the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? This is our faith. It's a faith that every Sunday we renew with the creed. We are so proud, as the youth is so proud to profess it in Christ Jesus our Lord. Dearly beloved, let us pray to God, the Almighty Father, for these his adopted sons and daughters, already born again to eternal life in baptism, that the Lord will graciously pour out the Holy Spirit upon them to confirm them with the abundant gifts, and through his anointing confirm them more fully to Christ, the Son of God. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who brought these gifts, these your servants, to new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, freeing them from sin, send upon them, O Lord, the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Give them the spirit of wisdom and understanding, spirit of counsel and fortitude, spirit of knowledge and piety. Fill them with the spirit of the fear of the Lord, through Christ our Lord. let us present our prayer to the Lord.
May the church always be filled with the gifts of the Holy Spirit, as those confirmed here today grow in enthusiasm and love for their faith. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the leaders of our city, the nation, and the world, that they may serve the people with wisdom and always work for peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our clergy, especially those celebrating with us today, that God will continue to fill them with his graces, we pray to the Lord. That the people of St. Joseph's, especially the catechists of St. Joseph's School and Religious Education, continue to be guided by the Holy Spirit in the education of our children. We pray to the Lord. For those who are sick or suffering and are in need of Jesus' healing powers, we pray to the Lord. For those who have died, that the peace of Christ be with them, we pray to the Lord. For our private and unspoken intentions, all of us, of all those gathered here today, we pray to the Lord.
O God, who gave the Holy Spirit to your apostles and willed that for them and their successors, the same Spirit be handed on to the rest of the faithful, listen favorably to our prayer and grant that your divine grace, which was at work when the gospel was first proclaimed, may now spread through the hearts of those who believe in you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Worship his holy name.
make that thing, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, Almighty Father. Receive in your mercy, O Lord, the prayers of your servants, and grant that, being conformed more perfectly to your Son, they may grow steadily in bearing witness to him, as they share in the memorial of his redemption, by which he gained for us the Holy Spirit, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you bestow gifts suited to every season, and guide the governing of your church in wonderful ways. By the power of the Holy Spirit, you come unfailing to her aid, so that with a heart always subject to you, she may never fail to seek your help in time of trouble, nor cease to give you thanks in time of joy, through Christ our Lord. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, with joy we proclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Felipe J and all the clergy. Remember also, Lord, your servants whom you have been pleased to confirm today by bestowing the Holy Spirit, and keep them in your grace.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in mercy, welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that in the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed Joseph, firstborn, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and then praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is you, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Thank you.
of the world blessed are those called to be succor of the law.
Christ. The body of Christ.
Let us pray. Accompany with your blessing from this day forward, O Lord, those who have been anointed with the Holy Spirit and nourished by the sacraments of your Son, so that with all trials overcome, they may gladden your church by their holiness and through their works and their charity foster their growth in the world. Through Christ our Lord.
Bishop mentioned at the very beginning, my name is Deacon Clay, for those I haven't been able to meet yet. It's great to be with you all at St. Joseph's, And congratulations to all the confirmandees. It's always a great inspiration to be present at another confirmation and to see your faith. You know, I was superior. Had the special privilege the bishop gave me those letters to read, and it was very edifying. Like I mentioned, to read and to see the richness and the diversity of your faith, and it brought me to deeper prayer. And as I was sitting there and seeing everyone come up to receive the gift of the Holy Spirit, it brought me back to the day in which I received my own confirmation, which was really not that long ago. I'm a graduate of Christ the King Catholic School, born and raised here in Jacksonville. And I went to Bishop Kenny High School and graduated there in 2011. So it wasn't that long ago when I was sitting in your seats. And I remember my confirmation very distinctly. And I can't help but think, but looking back now that I've been through seminary, and just 2 weeks from being a priest, I couldn't help but think as I saw you come up and saying amen to the bishop and responding, peace be with you, as you're being sealed by the gift of the Holy Spirit. It brought me back to the times in my life where there's been times of difficulty and great joy as well, those struggles as well, and knowing that through faith, as you all mentioned in those letters, and as you all have learned, through faith we believe that it's the Holy Spirit that gets us through those difficult times, that brings us back into communion with our families, with our friends, that reminds us that God is always with us. And I can give testimony to that in my own life. It was the sacraments of the church that really were the seeds of my vocation to the priesthood. But also to you young people, it was the love and the faith that my parents instilled in me as well. You're so blessed to be a product of St. Joseph's prep program, a product of St. Joseph's Catholic School, to receive the education that your parents gave you. And it was the faith of my parents, Carl and Susie, who really taught me what it means to be a man of God. And then in church, receiving the sacraments, going to confession on a regular basis, and receiving the nourishment of the Eucharist, it gave me the courage to know that I have a family here in the church. No matter what I do in life, I can always come back to the church and receive the sacraments. So I send that as words of encouragement to you. As I soon become a priest, I want to be a priest for and with you and your families, to journey with you side by side. We're in this together as a community of faith. It's been awesome being here at St. Joseph's with Father John, and Father Sebastian, and Father Vernon, and the other priests in the communities that come here. They've been great mentors to me. And Bishop reminded me in the homily, my confirmation saint is Saint Joseph. And when I came up to confirmation, I remember it was Bishop Gallione, and I was so proud to be confirmed. And I remember saying, you remember, he asked me, what's your saint? And I said, Saint Joseph. Wow. Because I was attracted to Saint Joseph because he was the father of Jesus. And I had no clue at that point that God would call me to be a priest. Junior year at Bishop Kenny, when I heard God and the silence of my heart says, Clay, what about priesthood? I would go to Mass there. Say, what about priesthood? And now I can look back and say that it was my confirmation. St. Joseph always had his hand, patron saint, always had his hand on me. Pray in intercession of your confirmation saint from this day out. Ask for his or her intercession to guide you. And then, God is so full of surprises. My first parish that will serve as a priest of this diocese in 2 weeks will be right here at St. Joseph's. The providence of God. God always has his hand in us. So thank you for your witness today. Know of my prayers for you and for any young people out there that may be thinking, maybe I'm called to be a priest. Maybe I'm called to be a religious or religious sister. Trust in that intuition. Trust in that whisper, because maybe God is calling you to follow him in that way, to be a sign of his love. Not only for your own family, but to the whole world. Know my prayers for you. If there's anything I can do for you and your families while I'm here at St. Joseph's, please don't hesitate to ask me. Always remember, we're in this together. God bless you and keep you.
So let us welcome and congratulate the new Kingdom of God. So may those who have received the sacrament of confirmation this liturgy, can you please stand up? Let us give them a hand. Thank you for being. St. Joseph's tradition for standing at your 2 feet today. And we also want to thank the parents, your parents, and all the sponsors, and your grandparents, and siblings who cannot be here and participating through stream of this Mass. So we thank the parents, sponsors, grandparents, siblings, all who helped you to become who you are today. Please be seated. When I thank the parents and sponsors, I certainly want to thank our amazing team of faith formation, our parish religious education program coordinator, Lourdes, and Lourdes' assistant, Sylvia, the school principal, Robin, assistant principal, Teresa, the 8th grade the teachers, Mary Catherine, Megan, and all other teachers who are here from the school, the catechists, all the catechists of the faith formation. Can you stand up? They're all in the back. That's fine. We do have an amazing team of faith formation, and we thank God for their hard work, their devotion and dedication. Thank you. Thank you again. Let's give them a hand. And to make this liturgy so special, we saw the honor God provided by the Knights of Columbus, the beautiful music provided by Frank and Beth Willoughby. We have the altar service, we have the sacristan Nadine, the special team of what you call taking care of the ushering for this Mass by Mike Fleming, and all those who are especially helping us with the streaming this Mass, Mike, the parish council president, and Jerry, who is also watching over everything going beautifully in this facility. Thank you, Jerry. But most important, I want to thank all the priests, especially Father Giovanni, who represents a host of priests who help our parish with so many cultural masses. So Father Giovanni takes care of the Albanian community. There are so many other priests helping our parish. So here, Father Giovanni represents that host of groups. Bishop mentioned about Father John. Last two years, Father John, you have been working hard with this small team of faith formation team to make this group so beautifully formed. Thank you, Father John, for your work. But let me ask all of you to join me to thank our beloved bishop, who so you may not be knowing yet, you know, this is his second confirmation this day. This morning he was in resurrection Next Tuesday, he will be completing his 9th year of being our shepherd of the Diocese of St. Augustine. 9 years ago, he was installed in the same sanctuary, in the St. Joseph's sanctuary. And he also completed 50 long years of his priesthood last May 30th. So we congratulate our bishop for his golden year of his priesthood. Thank you, Bishop, and congratulations. Bishop was so careful to point out to us that this is a year dedicated to St. Joseph, and we have our patron, the amazing St. Joseph, the patron saint of the Universal Church, and he's the amazing saint, and God will ask us to go to Joseph. So let us use that prayer card, and please stand, and let us recite our dedication to consecration to St. Joseph. Most of you have received this prayer card. Dear St. Joseph, God gave you the occasion and mission to be the husband of Mary, guardian of Jesus, protector of your holy family, and patron of the church. I consecrate and entrust myself to you and through you to Jesus in every aspect of my daily life. I ask you to be my guardian and protector in all the trials, tribulations, and temptations of my life. As I follow Christ on the path to eternal life, from the Lord, please obtain for me true humility of heart, purity of body, soul, and spirit, and a great love of God and my neighbor. By the grace of God, may all my thoughts, words, and actions, like your ways and ways in the Holy Family, be completely dedicated to Jesus now and always. Now, one more reminder that when we process down, keep the social distancing, but we have the photo opportunity with the bishop near the St. Joseph statue outside. So make yourself available, the teachers and the staff, and everybody will help you to be photographed with the bishop.
You know, we are already at 5 to 4. If we are almost on the vigil of Sunday, and this Sunday is the Holy Trinity. Holy Trinity, one God, is supreme source and outcome of our faith. And I would like to share a favorite poem of the same author I was talking at the homily, Jessica Powers, a poem called Doxology. It's a beautiful poem dedicated to the Trinity. And I would like the deacon, priest to be, to read it for us. And for you will be the first Mass, the Trinity, the first Mass that you celebrate as confirmandi, confirmed and fully initiated as Catholic.
Doxology. God fills my being to the brim with floods of his immensity. I drown within a drop of him whose seabed is infinite. The Father's will is everywhere, for chart and chance his precept keep. There are no beaches to his care, nor cliffs to pluck from his deep. The Son is never far away from me, for presence is what love compels. Divinely and incarnately, he draws me where his mercy dwells. And lo, myself am the abode of love, the third of the triune, the primal surge and sweep of God, and my eternal climate soon. Praise to the Father and the Son and to the Spirit, may I be, O water, wave and tide in one, thine animate doxology.
The Lord be with you. May God, the Father Almighty, whom he has made, you, his adopted sons and daughters, reborn from water and the Holy Spirit, and may he keep you worthy of his fatherly love. May his only begotten Son, who promised that the Spirit of truth would abide in his church, bless and confirm you by his power in the confession of the true faith. And may the Holy Spirit, who kindles a fire of charity in the hearts of the disciples, bless you and lead you, bless blameless, and gather us one into the joy of God's kingdom. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.